Here are the six principles of how people do things. They respond to authority. There are countless research studies. The Milgram experiment, for example, is about how people respond to authority. Frankly, and here's the thing, with superpowers come super responsibilities, right? You learn this stuff, you realize I can get people to do what I want. So I have a moral responsibility not to abuse that. The Milgram experiment showed that you could basically get people to shock other people, even to the point of them believing that they were giving themselves a heart attack or giving other people a heart attack by shorting out their pacemaker, if you simply put them in a room where they perceived enough authority, enough guys in lab coats, enough guys with clipboards taking notes and wearing goggles and making them feel like they were part of an experiment that was under a scientific authority. Like, people are frighteningly responsive to authority and the perception of authority. Reciprocity, do for others, they want to do for you. When others do for you, you naturally want to do for others. Scarcity, have you ever noticed how the last bite of your food tastes the best? Because it's the last, now it's gone. When things are scarce, well, literally at a sensory level, we perceive them to have more value, to produce more joy. Scarcity is a huge part. This is why every time you go on Amazon, it always says, or on any e-commerce store, it always says like there's only 6 units left, because we like to get one of the last things, right? That's one of the things that persuades us to take action when we think we're gonna lose the chance. Social proof, when we see other people doing something or other people being successful with something, we feel successful. The number, or we feel validated in making the same choice. The number one thing you can do on any website, on any sales offer, on any TV commercial, on any radio ad, on anything that's selling anything to get more people to buy is to get testimonials from other people who seem like ordinary people. That's the number one thing, because social proof is one of the most powerful things that helps persuade people to move forward. Commitment and consistency. People like being consistent. Once they make a commitment, they like sticking with it. The example I always give is, if you have a smoking problem, if you're trying to quit smoking, the number one statistically proven thing that you can do to quit smoking today is go on Facebook or go on your preferred social media platform and post, change your status to, just smoked my last cigarette. When you publicly proclaim something like that, you make a public commitment, you engage all of the body and the mind's natural desire to stay consistent with our commitments. Basically, we don't like being hypocrites, right? These are just personality traits. These aren't things that you have to try to muster up, or you have to try to, you know, pray and meditate over to say, I want to respond to authority. I want to respond to social proof. I want to engage in reciprocity. I want to, you know, have a desire that's driven by scarcity. I want a desire to be commitment. Like, this is all there already. You can't talk yourself out of it, and you don't need to talk yourself into it. Liking, I think this goes without saying. We like to, or we tend to do business, spend time, engage in financial transactions, engage in conversation, whatever it is. We like to engage with people we like, and we don't like to engage with people we don't like, right? It stands to reason. So if you want to succeed, what you have to do is you have to craft your environment so that all the environmental stimulus is aligning with these six aspects of your personality to push you in the direction that you want to go, or rather to pull you in the direction that you want to go. You want, think of these as like gravitational forces. These forces naturally pull us in a direction. So if you position your environment, if you get all the negative influences out of your environment, you change the people you're around, or you change the conversations you're having, or you change the media that you're feeding your brain, or whatever changes you gotta make. And I'm not saying fire all your friends, I'm just saying survey your environment and make sure that it's optimized to pull you using these forces in the direction of success. Then success becomes very easy. It becomes something that doesn't require willpower.